We return to Province Wide. Here again, CTV's Diane Verniel.
In North Dumfries, just west of Cambridge, you'll find the Berry Family Farm. In business since the 1890s, they've had to find ways to adapt to changing markets and now how to compete with foreign imports. Their main crop is asparagus, and how they're using it is nothing short of amazing.
Asparagus is the main crop at Tim Berry's family farm just outside Cambridge. As one of Ontario's biggest growers of the perennial plant, every year he collects about 30 tons of the produce.
We have 30 acres that we harvest every day in May and June every year.
And while many of us were complaining about this year's cool, rainy spring, for Tim it brought him a bumper crop.
This is probably the best asparagus I've seen in my lifetime.
Really?
In close to 40 years. Last year was probably the worst. I could have thrown in the towel last year, and this year I don't remember anything like it.
But the big challenge for this farmer is figuring out how to move this massive crop of local veggies.
We had to figure out a way of getting our selling more of our asparagus, and it just wasn't working, like going to the food terminal or wholesale, because of imported asparagus coming in.
And that imported asparagus is sometimes cheaper than his homegrown crop. So Tim and his family got creative and started thinking of other ways to use the green spears.
So we started playing around with asparagus soup and then just kept gradually adding it to other things so that now we can sell our asparagus year-round.
Teaming up with a number of Ontario retail partners, Tim started pumping the produce into other foods. And some of it is where you'd never expect to find strong flavored asparagus.
Asparagus chips, asparagus salsa, asparagus pasta sauce, asparagus relishes, pickled asparagus, asparagus seasonings.
In fact, his little retail shop on the family farm is a shrine to everything asparagus. But a few months ago, Tim got another bright idea.
I'm a hardcore coffee drinker, but I have been known to sip the tea.
And that's what led him to a partnership with Nobelia da Silva, owner of the Red Teapot.
I just suggested, why don't we take some dehydrated asparagus and play around with it, put it into a tea.
He challenged me to put asparagus into tea.
I think she looked at me like I was from Mars probably at first.
I guess I was sort of thrown back because I'm accustomed to working with fruits into teas, but when he asked me to put a vegetable into a tea, being asparagus, it's a very strong flavor, I thought, well, yeah, I'm game, I'll try.
And so Nobelia got to work. At her downtown shop, she mixes her own teas, which are prized by her loyal customers. Here's a blend name for her hometown.
This is our Tri-Cities collection, and it was one of our very first teas that we blended was our Cambridge tea, which was an herbal tea. And we blended that probably back in 2008. It has cranberries and cherry.
Waterloo and Kitchener blends soon followed. The first thing she wanted to know was if anyone else had ever made asparagus tea.
Well, we were curious when I started playing around with it to see if anybody else had attempted it. So, of course, we hit the internet and Googled it to see if anybody else had attempted to put dehydrated asparagus. And I think we're the first ones in Canada. I have yet to see that listed as an ingredient.
Nobelia got cracking with the first batch, called Gusto, after Tim brought in some dried asparagus.
He brought this green dehydrated asparagus in little bits.
Wow, like it smells like asparagus.
Oh yes, very intense.
Nobelia says her goal was to tame the strong taste and smell for the tea.
So our first one, our first choice wasn't green tea. We thought, let's do it with an herbal with no caffeine and see if, you know, because of the nutty profile. Asparagus has a bitterness, so we thought, how could we sort of lessen the bitterness? And the idea was to put it in with a rooibos tea that's naturally sweet and had a nutty profile.
That first concoction, says Nobelia, was pretty awful. Tim tried it and he agreed.
The first one that she brought was so strong because the dehydration process.
So it was back to the drawing board. Nobelia decided to try some other exotic ingredients, hoping for a better outcome.
We ended up blending it with almonds and rooibos and a couple of other spices to see if it would actually work. And it was horrible.
The advice Tim gave her after batch number two?
A little bit of dehydrated asparagus comes from a lot of fresh asparagus.
So finally, Nobelia decided to make a green tea, matching the color of the asparagus.
Then we tried to disguise the taste of asparagus. So we decided that we were going to put vanilla into it to mellow down that bitterness. And then we decided that we were going to put various spices into it, again, to disguise the taste of it.
The key was adding orange peel and vanilla.
The aroma coming off of this is just fantastic.
Yeah, and that's something that we pride ourselves on, is the freshness of our teas, because they're blended here in our back kitchen. We have about 30 signature teas that are ours.
There's also another little-known herb mixed in called Pau D'Arco from South America.
It is a bark from a tree, but the wonders of this is that it's antiviral and antifungal, and so it also mellows out the balance, or mellows out the taste in this tea.
The latest batch blended, Nobelia crossed her fingers and hoped the third time was a charm. She sent a sample off to Tim for testing and...
It didn't sound that good, but then once we tasted it, my wife and her friends and my daughters, they were the ones that just loved it.
Nobelia brewed up a pot for us so we could try it. It's a green brew she calls a wellness tea, owing to its antioxidants from the asparagus.
It doesn't taste like asparagus, does it?
No.
It's lovely.
That was the whole point.
So despite the strangeness of this idea, Nobelia and Tim's asparagus tea has been a hot seller in both their shops.
I think people are sort of taken back that they don't want to taste it, especially when we tell them that it has asparagus in it. But after they taste it, they actually do really enjoy the flavor.
This experience has got Nobelia thinking about other possibilities.
Who knows? Right now I'm definitely playing with the vegetables, so dehydrated carrots and various other things that I'm tinkering around with in the kitchen. So who knows what the next blend will be.
And for Tim, where his asparagus will show up next, he's been talking to a skin cream maker.
Some skin products with asparagus, because of course asparagus is an antioxidant and it's full of vitamin K.
Tim says thinking outside the box is keeping this fourth generation Ontario farm viable as the next generation of berries gets set to continue the family tradition.
Now, you heard Nobelia mention that her asparagus tea might be a first in Canada. We also searched and found one producer in California, but no one else in this country.